Hey guys, how are you doing? This is Caleb Dirksen here, and welcome to my first ever reaction video. And guess what? The Christmas season is around the corner, so my reaction video is going to be watching a Christmas movie. In this case, I'm going to be watching an obscure computer animated direct-to-video film known as In Search of Santa. Well, not necessarily known, since people barely talk about it on the internet. Now, the thing is with this movie, I grew up watching it as a kid. I remember watching it countless times on a VHS that I had of it from Disney and Miramax. And now I own said copy on DVD right here, if you can see it clearly. In North America, it was released by both Disney and Miramax, and internationally it was from Paramount. But now, Paramount owns part of Miramax, and now they pretty much released the movie recently on DVD in 2020 under their distribution. But nowadays, even though I remember watching it constantly as a kid, let alone during Christmas, I have seen that the reactions on IMDb and on wherever, they haven't been that good to the movie, even on its original release. And it's a shame because the stars of the movie are highly talented actresses and singers and whatever celebrities you may have. The talented stars that I'm talking about are Hillary and Hayley Duff, who both played Crystal and Lucinda respectively. And I remember Hillary Duff a lot, like from Lizzie McGuire, and listening to her music too. But now, let's see what I think about this movie right now. So, I got my PlayStation 2 right here, and the DVD is in there. I'm gonna be watching it from my CRT since the PlayStation 2 is connected to there. And I got my headphones plugged into the TV as well. So, hold on a second. There we go. And I got the controller right here so that I can start the movie. Alright, so, in 10 seconds, we are going to start watching In Search of Santa in 3, 2, 1, start. There's the logo right here.
On a snowy island where penguins love to flock, a colony of penguins stood at Royal Rookery Rock.
The narrator.
The penguin king and queen had recently been blessed with two perfect.
What is this CG? Like, these designs look like they came out of a Nintendo 64 game.
The first chick to hatch would inherit the penguin throne.
And who is it?
Chick arrived mere seconds before her twin.
And she is born. What a bundle of joy.
Call her Crystal.
Yep, Crystal is her name. Pistol!
And the shrillest shout, the second penguin princess.
And here's Lucinda.
Many shades of green, for only first hatched could be the future queen.
Oh boy. This is gonna begin a sibling rivalry. And now they're growing. Whoa. Oh, careful! These.
They called her Princess Clumsy, to her constant consternation.
And those.
Preferred to ice dance.
Cartoon sound effects are out of place.
Rather skip it, wouldn't you?
Yeah, they're
so stupid at parties.
Sometimes their mouths don't even move to what they say. What is with this?
Break a wing, Eugene.
I can tell that this is poorly aged. This is like Norm of the North quality animation. But this is a movie from 2004 and Norm of the North came in 2016.
Eugene the Fool.
Yeah. Eugene, the jester.
Hey, is this a hatch day party or a maitre d' convention?
Yeah, he's not funny at all.
I'm trying on.
Happy hatch day to you.
Happy hatch day.
The ice and cake look like plastic.
Have a nice trip.
The cartoon sound effects again? They're out of place! Oh boy. Oh, the effects look really cheap!
We are not amused. Chocolate! I think we, the terribly deep thinkers, agree.
Those deep thinkers look ugly.
Yeah. Loopholes? The law scroll, Mortmartimes.
Yeah. The other penguins
recently uncovered
feel like they came out of the backyardigans. They're like, they all remind me of Pablo. In my opinion.
I won't hear it.
That snowball throw looks cheap.
Sorry.
My fault.
It's like the effects were taken from the internet on a royalty-free website.
Mount Gigantic?
To the very top.
Like, not only does this remind me of Norm of the North, it also reminds me of Food Fight in terms of the low-quality visuals. The sky is falling. It's a sleigh bell.
Ouch.
And it hit her head.
Funny.
And that sleigh bell must have been lost from one of Santa's reindeer. It dislodged from his sleigh.
When it comes to the deep thinkers, I'm more chicken than penguin.
You think?
The little arrow keeps...
It's a compass.
N must stand for nowhere. S for somewhere. E is obviously
out. It's called a compass, you... Oh, it's Santa Claus.
He drives a sleigh pulled by flying reindeer.
My bell.
They match.
Ooh.
The Book of Santa Claus.
Yep, the Book of Santa Claus. So that's your source of information on the fat man with the long white beard.
And every Christmas Eve, Santa's flying reindeer.
Those drawings in the book look a lot better than pretty much everyone in this movie. When translated into CG, or at least this level of CG, a magic looking glass to tell if someone is naughty or nice. Oh, there are the guards.
Rest, Princess Crystal.
On what charge?
Aiding and abetting the forbidden simulation of flight, trifling with human beings. And corrupting penguin youth with human lies.
Now she's at court?
Sacrilege.
With the deep thinkers? A fishbowl? A skiing stick?
I shall prove to the court that the first two
a stream?
Are completely circumstantial. And the third, utterly preposterous.
And the
Princess
book.
Crystal could not have lied about Santa Claus because Santa Claus is non-fiction. Does this ring a bell?
Yes. Yes, it does.
Oh, I've seen that bell before.
Mm-hmm.
Did it not dislodge from Santa's sleigh, plummet from the sky, and wallop your sister on the royal noggin?
Oh, boy. That's the truth.
under oath. Sorry.
Failure. Why'd you have to do that, Lucinda?
There is a Santa Claus. I know it in my heart.
Your heart? Rubbish.
Thank you, Crystal.
You failed to prove that Santa Claus is real. Therefore, by default, he is unreal. Thereby, and consequently, and herein ergo, we, the terribly D-thinkers, rule that Santa Claus is a human lie.
But you don't understand! Why did you have to do that to Crystal? And this song?
We're the terribly deep thinkers. We're walking on my necks. Our bones are rolled in brittle, but our minds are sharp as tacks.
What are you gonna do to that place? Burn it down?
No!
I shouldn't have said that. You maniac! You burned it up! Darn you! Darn you all to heck! The Deep Thinker's Fortress. Or their lair. Or hideout. Or whatever. I don't know. Thank you for telling the truth, Lucy! Oh boy, now you've gone and betrayed the Deep Thinkers.
A penguin who can't swim in seal-infested waters. What was that?
You shouldn't have said that word.
Leopard seal!
A leopard seal? That leopard seal looks like it has a baby's face fused onto the body of a seal. Cheap explosions.
Many me hearties. First mate Bupkis Bill at you.
Bupkis Bill.
Time Bomb Tom.
The pelican. And the stork is Time Bomb Tom.
My sister Lucinda and Pup.
Pup, so that's his name? Captain Craig.
Nice.
Nice. Cheap lightning. Skeleton.
The ugliest and ugliest.
Oh, that is gross.
Whose habits are uncleanest and so fearsome.
Well, that's one. That's one gross thing in this movie.
Who's that tusky tank of terror who very rarely bathes?
He's known to boast and brag, the nefarious Captain Craig.
Ace of rabies, he's tookier than a shark.
That baby looks
from cute babies. He's
weird
to be trusted.
Or
he's a dirty
just awful.
The nefarious Captain Craig has decided to grant your request.
Since when did Captain Craig become nice again?
We're opening a fast food franchise of seafood restaurants with a pirate theme?
No, we're not. Even better than that.
Where did that come from?
And we, the new heirs to the throne.
A secure future makes a pleasant present.
Now you're gonna steal the throne?
Land ho! Land ho!
That's a polar bear. And that polar bear looks awful.
As you were. Ta-ta.
And that polar bear animation is awkward. All this jumbled CG. This jumbled Nintendo 64, PlayStation 2, GameCube CG animation. Yeah, sometimes the music can be out of place too. Like, this is from the 2000s and...
Elfman. How wonderful.
computer animation from the 80s or 90s don't look as bad as this. Elfman. Max Elfman.
Whatever you're selling, I ain't buying.
You're not selling anything.
Whoa, that elf scares me. Well, that elf's animation looks hideous.
No, it's just that I have a receding hairline and I'm a little elf-conscious.
If there was only a real professional artist behind this who left this 2D, then maybe it would have looked good. So that's Max Elfman. Yeah, by the way, this movie was originally supposed to be... Yeah, apparently this movie was supposed to be 2D from what I saw from a trailer that I found on YouTube.
Oh, Lucy, you said we'd find Santa when pigs fly?
When pigs fly.
But how could they just vanish?
Well, good foreshadowing, Lucy. Good job! Ouch! His nose!
Found what? An invisible wall!
Yeah, right.
Youch!
Lucy, we're here! We've arrived!
Rambling.
I don't see anything.
Rambling cartoon sound effects. Only visible to true believers. You are true believers.
Jolly and large! Santa! Santa Claus!
Yep! Santa Claus!
Yes! I see it!
And the wall is building up with bricks.
It's marvelous! It's
bricks, bricks, bricks galore! And they look cheap. Literally, this movie looks unfinished.
I said hardly.
Oh. Lighting. Military reindeer. Those human designs look ugly. And that mayor really reminds me of Mr. Monopoly.
Call it the spirit of Christmas, but it works all year round.
Those textures on Santa. God. I will admit that this movie does really look colorful, especially in this Christmas village or city. Those pirates deserve to be on the naughty list. Pixie dust.
No.
Oh. Too late? That dynamite turns into fireworks with flowers. I can really understand why this is direct to video. And candy! And teddy bears and toy soldiers.
My mastery of the martial arts is lesser known.
Turns into a karate master.
Leave this place. What about the treasure?
What? Oh my God! Why? Yeah, send him off! never to return.
The magic looking glass.
The magic looking glass.
Oh, Crystal. Where are you?
Eugene.
Eugene.
I miss you too.
There's more.
It's like a the FaceTime of 2004. Oh, the deep thinkers.
Thanks to our superior intellect.
Ah, yes. A photo album of Crystal and Lucinda's memories with Santa.
And now for the cherry on the sundae.
Oh, yeah. Santa's hat?
And finally, a single serving of magic flying dust.
Pixie dust. Oh yeah, the magic flying dust. And what's gonna come out? Oh.
Sawdust?
Sawdust? It's fake! And you got lumps of coal for being naughty. Now you're being nice again. And there goes the magic flying dust or pixie dust or whatever. And now they're doing a reenactment of the ending of Peter Pan, where Captain Hook's ship is flying back home.
May the wind always blow in your sleep.
A gold rock. See what happens when you become nice again?
What do you want? They've come to stop us.
Oh, on the contrary. We've come to...
Tricked again by the terribly deep thinkers.
This is a trick.
If this were a trick, why would we invite the entire colony to the Cave of Profundity?
Cave of Profundity. So that's their hideout. It's a trap! You tricked them! What? Not the hat!
No, you crossed the world and risked your lives, but
you threw it into the cauldron! That green smoke looks cheap too. Oh no, 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 no! And that cauldron boiling water looks like jello. Green jello.
Hurry, Pup, hurry!
Yeah, you go, Pup.
Princess Crystal,
set to the dotted line, please.
Yeah. More Mommy's mouth. Doesn't even match.
Someone, stop that seal!
And those guards are chasing awkwardly.
I'm no marine biologist, but this seal is just a pup.
Yeah, just an innocent little pup.
Who are you going to trust, our most dreaded predator, or us?
Button your beak, Agonesia.
Agonesia. That's her name.
Deep thinkers.
Yep, banish them off. Never to return again. Lost at sea.
God, what's that infernal sound?
That's Santa's sleigh. the sleigh bell falling. Christmas at the Arctic Kingdom of Royal Rookery Rock. Open! Ice skates. And fairy dust. Whoa, careful. So this is really the end? Oh yeah, fly. Fly like Peter Pan. Whoa, whoa, whoa. So is this it? Okay! Good! Starring the voice talents of Hilary Duff, Haley Duff, and they're pretty talented too. William R. Kowalczyk. Yeah. And that was it. Man, this movie. Yeah, I may have grown up with it as a kid, but maybe I should have turned off my brain for this is now, because oh boy, this hasn't aged well in the slightest. Yeah, you know, I can only say that this is the Norm of the North or Arctic Dogs of 2004. Yeah. I could understand why this was released direct to video because of the visuals. And my god, did it deserve to be so, because even the CG looks unfinished. Beyond belief. What was Miramax thinking? And like, what did I just watch? And now the only thing that I can do about it is get ready for the review. And so, the moral of the story is, if you ever decide to watch In Search of Santa, then you're pretty much gonna have to be in a turn off your brain state with this movie, because that's the only way you can really get through it. So, with that said, this is Caleb, over and out.